There was a recent article published in Biological Psychiatry in July 2019. This was published by Dr. Jessica Reed and colleagues, and they wanted to look at what the brain looks like during functional MRI before and after ketamine infusions. So they took two groups of patients. One was considered the healthy control, and another group of patients who suffered from major depressive disorder. They gave these two groups either ketamine, a 40-minute infusion at 0.5 milligram per kilogram, or a placebo saline infusion. And they used functional MRI brain imaging to look at the brain activity. And what they found was that in patients who had major depression, their brain activity was hyperactive in certain portions of the brain during the emotional processing test. And in the normal patients, they found that these portions of the brain were not hyperactive. And this is all before the ketamine infusion. And what they found after both participants had received ketamine infusion, they again looked at the brain imaging, and they found that that hyperactivity that was previously seen in patients with depression had actually normalized. So the bottom line of this article shows that after receiving ketamine infusion, these portions of the brain that were hyperactive during emotional processing in patients with depression had actually become more like the normal control subjects. So this is fascinating to think that ketamine can have this effect on the brain to basically make it a normal functioning that is seen in the normal healthy volunteer. There are a few limitations of this study because this was only just one infusion and they didn't look at a series of infusions, much like what we do at Reset Ketamine, is multiple infusions over a 2 to 3 week period. That's one consideration that they weren't able to look at the long-term effects. So there's definitely an opportunity for more research, for more neuroimaging, and this is just another cool mechanism of how ketamine is working in patients who have depression. If you have any questions or comments, please leave me a message below and share this with someone who may be suffering from depression or just curious about learning more about ketamine.